Back to Towering Pines. We're gonna do another garden tour. It's been a while since we've done a longer form video like this. You may have noticed recently that we've switched to doing more shorts. We've been doing about a short every day of something small going on in our garden, and we're planning to start doing these longer form garden tour videos roughly once a month. So let's get into it and see what's growing in the garden. So down here we have three blueberries down here at the bottom. They're down here because they get more water. This one here, you may notice, is not looking as good. It was unfortunately hit by the deer. We had a big storm that blew open a gate up there, and they came in, chomped on several of our plants, and you'll see later on some of them took some pretty hard damage from the deer, unfortunately. But it's still, I think it's coming back a little bit. Hopefully it will recover, and maybe next year we'll get some blueberries. Over here, we have our compost pile, which we're really starting to up the compost production a bit. We were able to use our original one this year, not a ton of it, but we used it to mulch some of our newer trees, and we really want more compost, though, more good dirt, because we did not have as much as we wanted. All right, we're gonna come up here to the main part of our garden. So in this front section here, it's not as green. A lot of the trees were put in this year and are newer. A couple are from last year. Over on this side here, we have some currants. We have a red, a white, and a black all along here. Not completely sure which is which. You may notice this one is kind of short. It was also hit by the deer along with the blueberry and several other trees. But other than that, they're looking pretty nice. We had a little bit of an issue with disease that we had to cut this one back a little more, potentially because of the deer, but it seems to be doing okay now. Right here, it's one of our saddest trees right now. This pear got hit hard by the deer after being hit by the deer last year as well. However, it is coming back. We've got lots of new leaves, surprisingly, even though it's taken two hard hits 2 years in a row. So we're hopeful, but let's hope it doesn't get hit next year. All right, coming this way, we have one of two new almonds that we planted this year. This one did get hit by the deer as well, but it's doing okay. It's doing okay. Down here is a pawpaw tree, which this, along with there's another one up this direction, where we thought they had died. They're getting a lot of sun, which we think was part of it, but they've come back, and this one in particular is doing pretty well. We're purposely letting this cherry tree wild grow up as some shade while they're young, and we'll potentially take it down when it gets a little bigger and is able to take the sun to hopefully prevent it from dying back as much. The second one right here, coming back from the base next to our key lime tree, which we're using as shade for this one. And this key lime is one of our citrus fruits, which do better in warmer zones, so we bring them out when it gets warmer for the summer and the warmer parts of spring and fall. It stays indoors in the winter, and there's this in-between period where sometimes we're bringing it in and out based on what the temperature is going to be that night. But these have been out for a while now. The lemon still inside, should be coming out soon. We come up this way. This is our second big tree. We had an original one, which I'll show you in a minute, but this one we bought this year, and it did get taken out by a frost, actually. We had a frost that wasn't that late, but because we had a lot of warmer weather before the frost, a lot of our trees opened up early, opened up leaves and buds, and so we did have a couple things get taken out by the frost, including, sadly, this fig. Our second fig. So right here, we completely cut it back to the base, but
We did have one that died all the way back last year. However, figs can come back from the root quite well, even in places colder than Georgia, much colder than Georgia. And it is coming back quite well from the root here. Down this way, we have our third beech tree added this year. It took some deer damage, but it's doing quite well. We actually left it flowered and produced a few peaches, and we left one on here. I'm not seeing it right now, but we did leave one on here, which typically are supposed to take all the fruit off the first year, but can you blame us for wanting to try one peach? So, another thing over here, these were planted last year. These are hostas, which are a flower with these beautiful leaves, and they actually got buried under the wood chips because they were smaller, had died back, and some of the people adding more wood chips to our lawn did not know they were there. However, there's two of them. They both have come back up through the wood chips, which we're very happy for. We're very surprised and happy to see. Over here is our second almond, which is doing well. Still small, but it's looking great. Up here is our second peach tree, which has several peaches on it. Let's see if I can, yeah, right there. This one. There's several more on here though. It's doing quite well. We've got some. This is doing second best of our three peach trees. Coming over this way, we have our original Colombian giant thornless blackberry plant, which did wonderfully last year, produced a lot. We were able to make multiple large batches of blackberry jam, and it is getting into producing. We'll have some blackberries soon. We've got flowers and some of the berries. They're all still green, but we're getting closer. Something interesting in here is we did plant peas back in February, and we were hoping that this would offer some shade as it got warmer, as peas cannot take the heat well, and they look absolutely fantastic. Have grown taller than any I have seen, however, have not produced a single pea for us, so we will have to wait and see if we get any. Hopefully that's coming soon. On the sides here and here, we had kiwis that we ordered this year and were taken out in the same frost that took out that fig that we saw earlier. And neither of them appears to have made it, so we were very sad about two failed attempts at our kiwis. Coming up in here is, this is the main portion of our garden, and it's looking beautiful this year. There is so much greenery and life and fruit and flowers, and it's very exciting. Down here, all around, is our strawberry patch, which is producing quite well. We've gotten some delicious strawberries, as has our dog, unfortunately, and the birds and the bugs. But even with all those other things chomping on them, we've still gotten some, luckily, and they are so good. On this side, we have one of our persimmons, which we have not yet gotten fruit off of, and we don't know yet whether we're going to get any this year, but we will have to wait and see. It's looking really nice. Down here we have comfrey, which we have in multiple places. We've been using it as a chop and drop. It grows very well and comes back so well, so you could basically chop this whole thing and use it to mulch the trees, and it will come right back and do very well. Right here we have one of our two asparagus patches, which this was the first year we got a decent harvest off of it. We got some very good asparagus. Very little made it to being cooked because it was delectable raw. It was crisp, crunchy, fantastic. And we then let it go after we've gotten a good harvest so that it will put some energy down into the roots and be good next year as well. Coming up this way, we have a cherry tree here and here. They both flowered this year. We're not really sure if there's cherries. The
these leaves, it's kind of hard to see, so we'll have to wait and see if there's any cherries coming or not. We may not know for a little bit still. Up here we have one of our apples, which are doing wonderfully. Look, it's harder to see on this one. I'll show you in a minute. We have baby apples coming. But right here we have baby apple coming in, and there's several more on here. So this will be our first year getting apples off of our trees, and we are quite excited. Right here, our largest, most vigorous tree is our peach from the first year we did this. It is got a lot of peaches on it. There's one here, here. Probably won't show up great on camera, but peaches all over this thing, and we are very excited to try those. We have not yet gotten peaches off of this. We had a couple that last year all did not make it to maturity due to bugs. Right here, before I forget, we have some lemon balm, which was transplanted from one of our raised beds and is doing fantastically in the wood chips. It's beautiful, it smells amazing. Over here, all along the ground here, you can see we have some Jerusalem artichokes. And they are coming up everywhere. These will grow extremely tall and shade out this area quite a bit more. Back here, we've got a blackberry here and a blackberry over there. Both of these were transplanted from cuttings off of our main blackberry back there that we saw earlier. And they are both flowering, and we're gonna get a few blackberries. They will be shaded out when these start to grow up, so we will never get quite as big of a crop off of these just because of the amount of shade, but we are excited that we're still gonna get some fruit off of them. We also have some flowers here from bulbs. We have some here, some over here. We've got some gladiolus, some dahlias, several others that are around the garden as beautiful pops of color coming later on. This is one of our wisteria plants that's doing quite well. Not flowering quite yet that I can see. Right here we have one of our other apples, which has got large clusters of apples coming in, multiple clusters like this. We'll have to thin it out a little later on, but it's going to produce a bunch of apples for us. Down here, we have another one of our herbs that we transplanted to the wood chips. This has done the best of all the ones that we tried transplanting. We transplanted several herbs from the bed a while back to the wood chips to see how they do when we were little. It was definitely experimentation. We didn't know how well they do growing in wood chips versus the raised bed soil, but by the two you've seen, they did quite well. This thyme is spreading very, very much. And we're really excited to see that. We love to have the herbs in the garden. We use them in our cooking, and they're good pest confusers to hopefully keep them from getting quite as much of our produce. Here is the herb bed. This year, unfortunately, it got hit hard by the frost, and some of our chives died off due to aphids last year, so it is very bare compared to last year. We do have sage coming back, a little bit of thyme coming back. So we had to transplant a new rosemary as our rosemary got taken out, and we've planted several things from seed, including dill and parsley, that will be coming up soon, so hopefully we'll get this bud filled out again soon. Up here we have our annuals area, where we grow most of our annuals. In the middle, we have our wisteria, which is doing wonderfully, has some beautiful flowers, and it's just a great place to sit in the shade. We love having this nice bit of shade in our garden because it gets hot in Georgia in the summer, and the spring and the fall, and most of the year. So it's a really nice spot. We have had some issues with some of our annual beds. We had a very nice mix of soil that we mixed up ourselves with compost and vermiculite and peat moss, and it was doing great but it depleted very quickly, and we decided to try ordering some soil to continue filling them instead of making our own. And we've had a lot of issues with this soil, just not growing stuff well. It's supposed to be a garden mix with compost in it, but it's full of rocks. It's really not a great texture, and we have had some concerns that there may have been pesticides or herbicides in it. We don't know though, so we have been taking it out and dumping it back along here, as we've had major issues growing anything in that soil. So this is kind of our first bed that we tried. We have, you can see there's some lettuce in here, and we actually have a couple volunteer sunflowers, but a lot of them died back, and they grew extremely, extremely slowly. These were planted like a couple months ago, and they are still this size. So as you can see, we're having issues with this soil, which is why in our other beds, we're taking out the soil before planting in them. And I'll show you later the difference with one that's planted in slightly different soil. Back here, we haven't yet planted this one out, so we just have it covered in mulch. And then in this one, we've got some carrots on the end there, getting close to harvesting, of a rainbow of colors, red and purple and orange, black, purple. So we're excited to get those soon. We have loved all the carrots we've gotten in the past. On this side of the annuals, we have some baby zinnias growing up. They're still quite small for now, but those will be coming up soon. Here in this bed, you can see we took out the majority of the soil, and this kale looks absolutely lovely, and it is quite tasty too, and it's got this gorgeous purple vein. And so we're hopeful that this bed does seem to be doing better. Along the back, we have some broccoli that's all doing great. We had a couple cauliflower that have mostly died off or are not doing well. They were planted at the same time as the broccoli. We're not exactly sure why those have not done as well. And we have some beans. They're small. They'll be really hard to see on camera, but we do have beans coming up as well. Back here, we have some more lettuce and spinach, as well as potatoes, which we've had in this bed for years and years, and we always go in and harvest a bunch, and yet there's always more next year, so we keep missing some of them. And then on this side, we also tried to plant in. It's mostly the poor soil that we're trying to get rid of, but we do have a couple turnips growing. Out of 2 out of 9, though, isn't great. Yeah, the soil kind of sucks. Coming back this way, right here, we have one of our grapes. We have, well, we had 4 grapes in total. This is one of 2 originals. So this one is doing quite well. We've got little baby grapes incoming, which we're excited for, as we lost all of our grapes last year to the deer, our horrible foe in the garden. However, this grape over here, we do not know why. We would think the timing would be similar. They're in similar locations. Yours do have fully died off. We had a couple buds earlier, and nothing ever opened up. It appears to be completely dead. We don't really know why. However, right here, we have a grape coming from a cutting that was, this is cut. It was used to be attached to the original grape and was cut, but it is rooted from the stem and growing a new grape. So our plan is to leave it here this year and then potentially transplant it to replace the one that died over here. We're coming towards the end of our tour, but right here is our second persimmon, which is also looking lovely, beautiful leaves. You may notice around the base of our trees, we've got this mulch. One of my brothers did some very hard work pulling a weed that we've had a lot of trouble with and just used it to mulch around the base of the trees to provide some protection for the soil and nutrients later down the road. This is one of our other strawberry patches, also doing wonderfully. Right here, we have our oregano. This is another one transplanted from the herb bed, the third of the ones that survived, and it's looking beautiful.
And then all along here, we have several different kinds of raspberries, which are in various states of budding and flowering, and so we'll be getting raspberries quite soon. Here we have our golden raspberries, which we tied up against the fence because they used to be spread out a little crazy, and tying them up against the fence hopefully will make them easier to harvest this year, but we've got some little baby raspberries coming in, and these golden raspberries are delicious. Over here we have one of two black cap raspberries, which as you can see is producing in full force. We're going to have mounds and mounds of raspberries. We have a second one, the same variety right here. Down in the corner is a regular red raspberry that is flowering quite a lot right now. We have one last raspberry over here that's starting to bud a little bit. Hasn't grown as vigorously as the others, but it is now starting to bud, and hopefully we'll get some off of this one as well this year. Last couple things, right here we have our lovely maple, which has been cut down once, but it came back from the root, which made us very happy, so we're probably going to continue to do that for a while, let it grow up, offer some shade, we can use the wood, and then we'll just chop it again and let it come back from the root. It's a beautiful little tree. And then our other two grapes are on the sides here, also producing quite a few little baby grapes coming up soon, looking wonderful. So that's it for the garden for now. We hope you've enjoyed this tour. It's so beautiful this time of year and so exciting, all the fruits and stuff coming up soon and flowers. So that's it. Well, we hope you'll come back again to Towering Pines and see our shorts. We're posting them every day right now, and we'll try and do these tours about once a month. Thanks for watching.